Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, we're going to be diving into walling. This is an application I reviewed some time ago. However, I didn't actually get to do an official review. Now we have this format. So for those who don't know, walling is an app that you can use to collect ideas and organize them for later. It looks like Notion, but acts like applications like Column and MyMind. It's an exciting twist. We're going to be diving into it today in the review, and at the end, we'll be giving it a score as well. So today's video is sponsored by Superhuman. You can check out Superhuman below and use the link as well to skip the queue, but here's a little bit more about them. Today's video is sponsored by Superhuman. Superhuman is regarded as the fastest email experience ever made. Their users get through their inbox twice as fast as before, with many seeing inbox zero for the first time in years. Curious how it works? Well, there's three parts to it. First, Superhuman delivers fast speed in-app with super speedy interactions, allowing blazingly fast startup, search, and sending mail speeds. Second, by introducing workflows. With carefully crafted snippets and keyboard commands, you can power through email at rapid rates, unknown in current email software. And third, some of the most powerful email triage out there. With split inboxes, email becomes easier to manage, with more urgent emails front and center and no email overflow, all personalized to your needs. Superhuman is currently invite only right now, with hundreds of thousands of people on the list. We've got a special link below. Head to superhuman.com/keepproductive and learn more there. Thank you to the folks at Superhuman for sponsoring Keep Productive this month. Okay, so here we are with walling. Now, before we begin, I'll get some of the more granular details out of the way. Walling is available on desktop in Windows and Mac editions as well. And you can also download a Chrome and Firefox extension for clipping, and they do make it available through web. At the moment, they don't have an iOS and Android application. However, I believe they're running a test flight edition on iOS for some of the users who want to test it out. Tell you about pricing. Pricing wise, it's not too bad. They have a free plan that is up to 100 bricks. We'll talk about bricks in a minute. It has unlimited walls, up to 3 members per wall. You get access to the Connect Wizard, which I'll explain later, and also the ability to collaborate on and share walls. I want to keep saying boards, I don't know why. They do have a paid plan, which is $4 per month. I believe that's the annual pricing, however, so maybe $5 per month billed monthly, but $4 billed annually. So round about the Notion sort of pricing when it had a pricing. But with that plan, you get unlimited bricks, invite unlimited members to your walls, global search, which includes the ability to identify text, colors, and objects in images, priority support, and everything on the free plan. So there are limitations in the brick limits of 100 when you're using the free plan, which is a little bit of a pain. So this whole idea of walling is built off a premise of collect, connect, and plot out. So basically, let me break it down pretty simply for you. Collect is basically picking up ideas and things inside of an area called Daily Desk. Connect is basically allowing them to have tags and connect them to a new project or board that you may have created. And finally, plot out is where you use your folder or your board or wall to actually organize and plan a certain project. So it's much more of a process-led application than, say, applications like Notion and Trello that sort of let you free rein in the experience. So I have the free plan in front of me. I'll probably do a premium-based feature, so do make sure to check out more videos as we talk through this. So I'm going to create a project about getting a house, and I'm looking sort of at ideas and things like this. So I'm going to use firstly the Clipper, which is available on Chrome. It is also available. So as you can see here, it's detected the article. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put asking price article. And I'm also maybe right about here. and I'm going to save it into my daily desk area. Naturally, you could automatically save it into a project that you already have or a wall you already have, and you can add these nodes up here. However, I'm going to talk through the Connect Wizard and how to bring that together. So once I save it, if I go over to walling, it's arrived, the sync works pretty fast, and what I can do from here is actually add a node to it. So I'm going to call this one Home Buying Research, and I'm going to go ahead and create it. So that node is created and it is available through Connect. So before I actually go ahead, I'm going to go ahead and create a new wall for house buying. Spelt buying wrong. You can also change the icons for this one. So if I wanted to find one that had a house on it, and I'm going to make a section called research, another section called finance, and then I'm also going to make a section called moving. So I've got my primary sections ready. So this works very similar to applications like Todoist to some extent. You can separate things in sections and naturally start adding stuff to them. So if you want to add to them and automatically work on the project, you can use the new brick feature. Let's demonstrate how the actual collect, I've collected something, connect, and obviously plot out works. So I'm going to go over to connect, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to find anything that I've tagged with the node home buying research. You can connect two nodes at once if you want to, and that's helpful if you've got, say, notes inside of a specific book on a specific topic, and that could be helpful if you wanted to create like a wall dedicated to a specific area or notes that you want to sort of make a collection of. So as you can see here, what I can do down here is actually go ahead and make a new copy and move it to house buying. And I can move it to a specific section as well. So in this case, it's research. And as you can see, if I go down to house buying, I can move it into relevant area. But I can do that with multiple bricks. So if I had a ton of articles that were about home buying, I could automatically organize them into the relevant areas. And if I had multiple ones just about home buying in general, I can move them down through there. So the idea behind this is to help you to go through a collect, connect, and plot out process. And once I'm in here, I can start working on the section. So for example, if I add a new brick, I could say things to do. If I'm working very specifically on an item, I can pop it up here and make it more central. I can also use a range of formatting as well to change things around, including adding links, images, files, and much more. If I wanted to as well, I could even create a brand new wall out of this. So we can also export the wall into a range of different formats, PDF, HTML, Markdown, or JSON, but I can also share it using the shareable link, which allows up to 3 people in the free account. Now, one of the features that I talked about a few weeks ago was the graph ability. So as you can see here, as you add nodes, you can make these obviously bigger and be able to see, you know, what specific items you've got in the home buying research section. So if I added more and I added different notes and connected them to projects, it would help grow that graph. Now, when you go, say, to capturing ideas for tomorrow, a brand new daily desk appears. So any ideas you create will be landed on this desk, but as you move forward, they will no longer appear, which is quite a nice because it's replicatory of your desk experience. Now, as I said, they do have a Firefox version, and there are a few examples of some projects, for example, redesigning the website, that makes it look a lot more attractive. You can add your designs down here. You can resolve specific bricks as well. You can add in thoughts and collaborate with other people. So it actually does make a nice team ideation setup as well. Now, inside of the setup as well, you can see how many bricks you've used in the free plan. You can change it over to dark mode if you want to, and even go into settings and change your default page. So if you wanted to land on a specific area, like you could create yourself an inbox wall inside of there, then that could be quite good. So all in all, walling do keep the roadmap pretty updated. They've post pretty regular change logs. So I feel like this application is a little bit of a hidden gem because it, like Tasking, I say, does a lot more than you expected to. And when you compare it to applications like Columns, which is very similar in design and I guess sort of functionality to some extent, helping you to collect things and organize them, and also MyMind as well, because they've got that connecting ability to help you to automatically tag things and do that with images and colors. But I think this works a little bit better. Although that's locked under premium, it's definitely something that I think encapsulates personal projects and also idea collection a lot better than these sort of applications, in my opinion. Yes, they do need to add an iOS application and Android one in the next couple of months for sure. And it would be nice to have global search inside of the free plan. That's something that I would definitely think would be available inside of a plan. But then again, $4 isn't going to break the bank necessarily with an application like this. Could be a little bit cheaper. $3, I'd say, would be more of a better price for this, especially when you tally up all of your other tools as well. It's not going to replace Notion, but if you're looking for an application that takes you through a process and works a little bit like you would with ideas, then this is a cool application. So what you've all been waiting for, the review side of stuff, for design, I'm going to give it a solid 9. I think the design is really attractive. They keep up the experience pretty updated, and I love the design. It definitely looks really attractive. Notion-esque, but have a little bit more sort of bear-like animation to it. Features-wise, I'm going to give this a 7 because I think it's really, whilst it's good, it's focused more on ideas, and I think task management, it would be pretty complicated to do something like that in there. Pricing, again, I'm going to give it a 7 because I think it could be a little bit cheaper, if I'm honest, because this is only an additional experience to something you probably already use, like a wiki. I don't know whether somebody would entirely replace it from an application like Evernote or Notion. Usability, again, I'd say 7 again. You do have to learn it, and you do have to sort of embrace their approach to productivity, whilst other applications give you a little bit more freedom. And finally, my opinion on it. I think it's definitely an 8 from me. I think this is a really attractive application. As I say, underrated in the market. So if you well that through, that's a 38 over 50. If you do the maths, that's a 7.6. And if you compare that on IMDb, you'll get movies like Kick-Ass and Harry Potter 6. Kick-Ass was a good movie. Harry Potter 6 was also a good movie. But Harry Potter 7 Part 1 is dreadful. So hopefully it doesn't continue. I'm joking. But you know what I mean. This application's really interesting. I think it's got a really exciting future in the market. Anyway, folks, I'll see you in a future video. Make sure you're subscribed and do check out the Obsidian Made Simple course that we launched very recently. Cheerio, folks. Bye.